Am I showing you the correct slide? I think we finished this one, this question on floral design in the last class.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
I'll let you do. Continue with this. We are still to do this, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, I'm sure we can do it. Start working. Somebody's mic is enabled. Kindly disable your mic. Children, all of you look into your microphone. If it's enabled, please disable it. What's the area of one triangular piece? What's the semi-perimeter of the triangle?
60, ma'am.
60. S is equal to 60. What about the area of one triangular piece? Yes?
200.
Ma'am, actually, I wrote this question in the last class, ma'am.
Come again, Kanishka.
Ma'am, actually, you have teach this question in the last class, ma'am.
We finished this, is it?
Yes, ma'am, we have completed this.
Oh.
I have written that, ma'am. And I have to screenshot also.
Of the answer?
I have the answer.
You have a screenshot of the answer, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, children.
Yes, ma'am, I have this only, ma'am.
Oh my God, all right. But I don't remember doing this in the last class.
Ma'am, I too don't remember.
Yeah, I remember stopped here.
Actually, you showed the floral design, ma'am. Next, you went and showed the 17th one.
Fine, fine. Okay, but anyway, we'll anyways just do it in the class now. Okay, thanks, Kanishka, for that.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, but so children, I'm not told to take the screenshot, I think so, ma'am, this one.
Okay, fine. We'll not spend time discussing that, Shivani and Kanishka. Thanks anyways, children. Let's work it now. If you have completed, fine. Otherwise, let's do it now.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. So what I have done with 60, 40, 10 and 10 is, I have written 60 as 6 into 10. I have written 60 as 6 into 10, 40 as 4 into 10. You can see the two 10s, 10 and 10 here, 10 and 10 here. I have written 40 as 4 into 10 and 60 as 6 into 10. So like that, we have four 10s under the square root. So two 10s out of the square root. Now we still have a 6 and 4. 6 is 2 threes are and 4 is 2 squared. So from 2 twos, 1 2 out. So 100 into 2, 200, 200 root 6. The value of root 6 will be given to you, 2.45 into 200, 490 centimeter square. But we are supposed to find how much cloth of each color is required for the umbrella. Have I completed the answer? No, I have not completed the answer. I have not written the last line. I have not, you know, like typed the last line. All right. So how much cloth of each color is required for the umbrella? See here, this umbrella is made by stitching 10 triangular pieces, 10 triangular pieces of cloth of two different colors. So 5 pieces of one color, the remaining 5 pieces are different color. 10 triangular pieces, 10 triangular pieces. So 5 pieces, 5 triangular pieces of one color. So say the colors red and blue have been used. So 5 triangular pieces of red and 5 triangular pieces of blue. Now what we have found is the area of one piece, that is the area of one triangular piece. The question is how much cloth of each color is required for the umbrella. So how should you complete the answer? After finding the area of cloth, no, this is not the area of cloth of each color. I made a mistake in typing here. What is 200 root 6, children? What is 200?
The area of one triangular piece.
Yeah, it is the area of one triangular piece. And how do we find the area of cloth of each color required? What will be the answer? Tell me in root 6.
Ma'am, 200 root 6 into 10.
Root 6 into.
Okay, I'm just, let me listen to everyone's answers. Okay, you say 200 root 6 into 10, all right?
Ma'am, for one color or both the colors, ma'am?
No, that's what. So just read this question. Answer this one. How much cloth of each color is required for the umbrella? How do we answer this?
Ma'am, we should 200 root 6 into 5, we'll get the color of one.
Okay.
One we'll, color.
Give us the cloth. The cloth. Amount of cloth you need for?
One color, ma'am.
One color. Okay. Okay. These are the only two possibilities. Either you have to multiply by 5 or 10, but the correct one is by 5. So 200 root 6 is the area of one triangular piece. Now of a particular color, there are 5 pieces. So the area of a particular color, there are 5 pieces. 5 pieces, 5 triangular pieces of one color, 5 triangular pieces of another color. How much cloth of each color is required? Each color. So 200 root 6 into 5. 200 root 6 into 5.
1000 root 6, ma'am.
1000 root 6.
So 1000 root 6 centimeter. I'll correct this slide and show you the correct answer in the next class. Or I'll share the picture on WhatsApp with you. I'll correct this and share the picture on WhatsApp with you. So what is the found there? 200 root 6 is the area of one triangular piece. So area of area of five triangular pieces. Area of five triangular pieces will be 200 into 5 root 6. So 1000 root 6. So that is the amount of cloth of one color required. Or of each color required. We need 1000 root 6 centimeter square of one color, and the same 1000 root 6 centimeter square of another color. So the answer, area of cloth of each color is equal to 1000 root 6. 1000 into 2.45.
If I take root 6 value as 2.44 means, ma'am?
The value of root 6 will be provided to you in the question. I have found the decimal value. You can leave it as root 6. The value will be given in the question. So all of us will get the same answer. If it is given as 2.44, you have to take it as 2.44. So children, here it's about calculating. So 16 into 40 into 10 into 10. 2 tens, 1 ten is going to come out. 60 into 40. I've written 60 as 6 into 10. And 40 as 4 into 10. So like that, we have 4 tens, 2 tens out of the square root. Then with the 6 and 4, 6 is 2 into 3. And 4 is 2 squared. So from 2 twos, 1 2 out. There's only 1, 2 and 1, 3 under the square root. So that remains as root 6. 200 root 6 centimeter square. Oh yeah, I think Kanishka is right. Kanishka and Shivani. I remember talking about this also.
We have completed, ma'am.
We completed, ma'am.
Oh yeah, we were in this right trapezium. Oh my, we're wasting time today. 20 minutes up. I think we start with this one. Yeah, I started explaining this and I said I will need another 10 minutes to complete, so we'll continue in the next class. Oh yeah, yes, yeah, right. Children, we finished all this. Without wasting any more time, let me start with this, the correct one. Yes, we are actually here. A field is in the shape of a trapezium whose parallel sides are 25 meters and 10 meters. A field, here ABCD, is in the shape of a trapezium. AB is parallel to CD, whose parallel sides are 25 meters. So AB is 25 meters and CD is 10 meters. The non-parallel sides are 14 meters and 13 meters. Non-parallel sides, AD and BC, the non-parallel sides are 13 and 14 meters. So you can mark 13 here, 14 here, or 13 here and 14 here. Okay, find the area of the field. Now we know that the formula to find the area of a trapezium is half sum of the parallel sides, that is half AB plus CD, sum of the parallel sides, into the distance between them. So here we have constructed CL, which represents the distance between the two parallel sides. But we do not know the length of this line segment CL. The formula is area of a trapezium is given by half into sum of the parallel sides, that is AB plus CD, half of AB plus CD, that we know. So half of 25 plus 10 into the distance between them. We do not know the distance between the two parallel sides. CL represents the distance between the two parallel sides. We don't know that. We're not given the value of CL. So you cannot use now, as of now, we cannot use a formula to find the area of the trapezium. We can use the formula only when we find the length of the line segment CL. So what we do is we divide the trapezium into two plane figures. we divide the trapezium into two plane figures, one parallelogram and another triangle. How? By drawing CE parallel to AD. I repeat, we divide the trapezium. Trapezium is a plane figure. We divide the trapezium into two plane figures, one parallelogram and another triangle. Now, don't say these are two different triangles. One triangle, this one triangle, this one triangle. We divide the trapezium into this triangle. See, I'm going over it. We divide the trapezium into one triangle and one parallelogram. So the area of the parallelogram, the sum of the areas of the parallelogram and the triangle, area of parallelogram plus the area of the triangle will give us the area of the trapezium. Area of the parallelogram plus the area of this triangle will give us the area of the trapezium. CL is a line segment that represents the distance between the two parallel sides. We do not know the length of the line segment CL. So now we are not able to use the formula to find the area of the trapezium. Construction through C, draw CE parallel to AD. Parallel to AD. Now what happens in the quadrilateral AECD? What happens in the quadrilateral AECD? Since AB is parallel to CD, it implies AE, which is a part of AB. AE is a part of AB. So if AB is parallel to CD, then a part of AB, AE, will also be parallel to CD. Parallel, we are not talking about equality. It's about being parallel. So since we know that AB is parallel to CD because they're the opposite side, they're the parallel sides of a trapezium. Because it's a trapezium, they're the parallel side. We know they're the parallel sides of the trapezium. So AB is parallel to CD because it's a trapezium. So a part of AB, AE, AE is a part of AB, AL is also a part of AB. EL is also a part of AB. All these portions will be parallel to CD. EL is parallel to CD. LB is also parallel to CD. EB is also parallel to CD. AE is parallel to CD. So like this, in the quadrilateral AECD, AE is parallel to CD because ABCD is a trapezium. CE is parallel to AD by construction. Through C, we draw CE parallel to AD. So this side is parallel to this side, opposite sides parallel. CE is parallel to AD by construction. In a quadrilateral, when both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel, it is a parallelogram. In a quadrilateral, when we have both pairs of opposite sides parallel, then it is a parallelogram. I repeat the entire process. So ABCD is a trapezium. You can mark ABCD in your own way. You can mark ABCD like this: A here, B here, C here, and D here. Okay, so by this figure, ABCD is a trapezium in which AB is parallel to CD. By this figure, AB is parallel to CD. We have marked the parallel sides 25 meters and 10 meters. And the non-parallel sides AD and BC, they measure 13 and 14 meters. I told you can mark 13 here, 14 here, or 14 here and 13 here. Since we do not know the distance between the parallel sides, we construct CL, which represents the distance between the two parallel sides. Now we are going to divide the trapezium into two plane figures, one parallelogram and one triangle. And for that, the construction is through C, we draw CE parallel to AD. We draw CE parallel to AD. So now when you take up the quadrilateral AECD, when you take up the quadrilateral AE CD. We are talking about the opposite sides of the quadrilateral. We are talking about the opposite sides of the quadrilateral. AE is parallel to CD. AE is parallel to CD because AB is parallel to CD. So one pair of opposite sides parallel. Now the other pair, AD is parallel to EC or CE. DA is parallel to CE. That is by construction. That's by construction. So now in this quadrilateral AEDC, both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel, and hence AECD is a parallelogram. Now that it's a parallelogram, we have many other properties. We have proved AECD is a parallelogram by showing that both the pairs of opposite sides are parallel. Now that it's a parallelogram, we can use all the other properties of a parallelogram. In a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. In a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides are equal. So we know that CD is 10 meters. AE will also be 10 meters. This is a parallelogram. In a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. CD is 10 meters. So its opposite side AE will also be 10 meters. AD is 13 meters. The side opposite to AD is CE. CE will also be 13 meters. CE will also be 13 meters. Now, AE is 10. But the full thing, AB is 25. AB is 25. AE is 10. So the remaining portion of AB, EB, will be 25 minus 10, 15 meters. EB will be 15 meters because the full thing AB is 25. AE is 10. So EB will be the full thing 25 minus 10, 15 meters. EB will be 15 meters. Now what we observe is, when we take up the triangle BEC, we have found out the lengths of all its three sides. When you take up the triangle BEC, we realize that we have got the lengths of all the three sides. BC being 14 meters, EB being 15 meters, and CE being 13 meters. This is 13, this is also 13. CE is 13. And EB we just found 25 minus 10, 15. And BC is equal to 14. So what you're going to do is, you're going to find the area of this triangle. You're going to find the area of the triangle BEC using Heron's formula. You're going to find the area of triangle BEC using Heron's formula. Now, once you find the area of the triangle using Heron's formula, say it is, just for example, say it is, say 200 meters square. Supposing, the area of triangle BEC is equal to 200 meters square. Now, when you apply the formula half base into height to find the area, that also will give you 200 meters square. Now, the area of this triangle can be computed in different ways. You can use a Heron's formula. The same you will get when you use a formula half base into height. But we did not use half base into height because we do not know the height of the triangle corresponding to this base. So at this point, say we found the area of the triangle using Heron's formula and it works to 200 meters square. Say it works to 200 meters square. So now you say half into base BE, which is 15 meters. Half into base BE, which is 15, into height CL is equal to 200. We know that the area of this triangle is 200 meters square. We found using Heron's formula. The same will be the answer when you use the formula half base into height. Area of the same triangle, it will be the same whichever formula you use. You cannot get different answers for the same triangle. So once you find the area using Heron's formula, equate it to half base into height. Half base into height is equal to 200. Half into base BE, that is 15, into height CL is equal to 200. When you work this, you can find the height of the triangle. The height of the triangle is also the height of the parallelogram, is also the height of the trapezium. CL is the distance between two parallel lines. CL represents the height of the triangle. CL represents the height of the parallelogram corresponding to the base AE. CL is the height of the parallelogram corresponding to the base AE. So see, the altitude falls on AE produced. The altitude on AE, when you draw the altitude on AE from D, no, this is a different information. Okay, let me just finish this. So once you find CL, now you can apply half sum of the parallel sides into distance between them to find the area of the trapezium. Or you can find the area of the parallelogram, the area of the triangle, and add both. Already we got the area of the triangle. You can find the area of the parallelogram and add the sum of the areas will give you the area of the trapezium. Anyways, you can do it. Now, I was talking to you about the altitude. CL is the altitude to the base AE in parallelogram AECD. CL is the altitude on the base AE. It doesn't fall on AE, it falls on AE produced. So the altitude from CC, altitude is always drawn from the opposite vertex or opposite vertices. Altitudes are always dropped from the opposite vertex or opposite vertices. Now, when you regard AE as the base, you can draw the altitude from D. That will fall inside the parallelogram. See, when you drop the altitude from D like this, from D, that altitude will fall inside the parallelogram on AE. But when you try to draw the altitude from C, you cannot draw like this. It's an altitude. You cannot go like this. It should make 90 degrees with the base or the base produced. So CL makes 90 degrees, not with AE, but with AE produced. Okay. Let me show you the answer. Please make use of the working. Complete this now, children. This is an important question. Please understand what was worked here. I explained all this. Just in case you have any doubts, please ask me. Please work the answer now in the class. Very simple yet very important question. You can also use the formula to find the area of a trapezium. Half sum of the parallel sides. Half of 25 plus 10. Parallel sides, 25 and 10, not 15. Parallel sides of the trapezium, 25 and 10, into distance between them, 56 by 5. 56 by 5. Get the same answer. 196. Let me know when you're done, children. Is it over, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, follow the same procedure. Work this one.
Do we want to do the same, ma'am?
Sorry?
Do we want to do this, ma'am?
Yeah. Yes. Please, yes. Please copy the question. The figure will not be provided, children. You should know how to draw the figure. First, draw a trapezium, ABCD, or you can even mark it PQRS, MNOP, whatever. First, you need to draw the trapezium, and then that construction CE parallel to AD, and also the altitude. H. Here the altitude is called H. Earlier they marked it CL. Anything is fine. Here they have not marked the point of contact here. Instead they have called the line segment H. What's the semi-perimeter of the triangle?
Ma'am, 20?
Is it 21?
No.
Is it 21, ma'am?
Yeah, 21. Shreyas, 21. What are the sides? Yeah, 21. Shreyas, what are the sides of your triangle? What are the lengths of the sides of your triangle?
Ma'am, 13 plus 14 plus 12.
13. What's the length of CE? What's the length of CE?
Sorry, ma'am, 15.
15. What about BE?
Ma'am, BE is 25 minus 13, 12, ma'am.
12. And BC is 15. So 15 plus 15, 30. 30 plus 12 is 42. 42 divided by 2 is 21. Yes, what's the area of the triangle?
Ma'am, is it 18 root 21, ma'am?
18 root 21?
Yes, ma'am, 18 root 21.
18 root 21 is right. Good.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Hitesh is very active now. I'm very happy about it. Good, Hitesh.
Thank you, ma'am.
Very good. What's the height of the triangle?
Ma'am, is it 3 root 21?
Yeah, 3 root 21. Yes. Yes, Kanishka, you're right. 3 root 21. Just in case others need help, I'm just showing you the answer slide. So in this figure, which is the path? Okay, let me wait for you to finish. I'll just wait for 2 minutes. Complete it. All right, children. So which is the parallelogram here? Name the parallelogram in this figure.
ABCD, ma'am.
A?
ECD,
ma'am. Okay, I think I heard ADCB.
AECD, ma'am.
AECD. Okay.
D.
AE. AECD is the parallelogram. Name the trapezium.
ABCD, ma'am.
Name the triangle.
BC.
AD is parallel to? AD is parallel to?
AD, ma'am.
AD. 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 D for doctor.
CD. C.
C. A as in animal, B as in doctor, AD is parallel to?
CE, ma'am.
So since AD is, okay, now AECD is a parallelogram. What is the property of a parallelogram we're using here?
Half is the base into it, ma'am.
No, what is the property? What is the property of a parallelogram we've used here? In this answer, to find the sides. To
parallel, find... ma'am. Parallel sides.
Okay, parallel sides what? What property have we used?
Opposite sides are equal.
Yeah, in a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. We've used that property here. In a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. ABCD is the trapezium. ABCD is a trapezium. With the parallel sides 25 centimeters and 13 centimeters. So see, this side looks longer. So we take 25 here and not 13. This side is longer. By this figure, you can make this side look longer. Whichever side in your figure, according to your figure, whichever side looks longer, that will be 25. See, these are the two parallel sides. Of these two parallel sides, AB is longer than CD. So give the longer measurement to AB and the smaller one to CD. So between 25 and 13, 25 here and CD here. I'm sorry, 13 here. Non-parallel sides, 15, 15. Construction, CE parallel to AD. Construction. And this H is the altitude of the triangle, the altitude of the trapezium, as well as the parallelogram. In a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. So CD is 13, AE is also 13. AD is 15, CE is also 15. opposite sides are equal. AD is 15. So CE is 15. CD is 13. AE is also 13. So EB will be 25 minus 13, which is 12. So find the area of the triangle using Heron's formula and equate it to half base into height to get the altitude. And then see here, in the earlier sum, I think I did it like this. You can do it both the any ways, children. So here, see, I found the area of the parallelogram. I found the area of the triangle. Triangle we already found. So found the area of the parallelogram, and the area of the trapezium will be the sum of the areas of the parallelogram and triangle. You can do it like this. When you're calculating the area of the parallelogram, this is the earlier one. When you're calculating the area of the parallelogram, be careful, base into height. Base of the parallelogram, AE. Base of the parallelogram, not the trapezium. Base of the parallelogram, AE. Height of the parallelogram, CL. CL. AE and CL. AE into CL, base into height. Here we found the area of the trapezium by finding the sum of the areas of the parallelogram and triangle. You can also do it like this. You can directly find the area of the trapezium using the formula. You can also find the area of the trapezium using the formula half sum of the parallel sides into distance between them. So parallel side of trapezium, 25 and 13, fully 25 and 13, 25, 13. Yes, children, in case you have any questions, some doubt, something not clear, please ask me. So this is the area of the triangle using Heron's formula. Equate the same thing to half base into height. Equate the same thing to half base into height. When you find the area of the same triangle using the formula half base into height, you should get the same answer, 18 root 21. So half base into height, half into base of the triangle, base of the triangle into height of the triangle. So 6h is the area, but that area 6h is equal to 18 root 21. When you find the area, it is 6h, but that area 6h is equal to 18 root 21. So like that, find h. Is another way of working. Otherwise, you can follow the same thing. See, I just did it in different ways. You can also do like this. Write the area and substitute the value of area here below this is equal to half base into height. Here, half base into height, half into 12 into h. So the area is 6h, but 6h is equal to 18 root 21, equating the areas. All right. I'm showing the next slide. Yes, work this, children. Please write the question. Now, if you have to find the area of triangle ADC first, ADC, supposing, or say in this figure, you have to find only the area of triangle ADC. What is the first thing you will do? Children, I've thrown a question. If in this figure we have to find the area of only triangle ADC, area of triangle ADC, what is the first thing you will find? We have to find the area of triangle ADC.
AC we have to find, ma'am.
AC, ma'am.
Yeah, we need to find the length of the line segment AC. To find the length of the line segment AC, will you use Pythagoras theorem in ADC or ABC?
ABC, ma'am.
ABC,
ma'am.
ABC, ma'am.
A?
BC, ma'am.
Shreyas, repeat. A?
ABC, ma'am.
ABC. Why not ADC? Why not?
Ma'am, because B is 90 degrees, ma'am. Not B is.
Because ADC is not a right triangle, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Pythagoras theorem can be applied only in a right triangle, not to every other triangle. Pythagoras theorem holds good only in a right triangle. In fact, it is meant only for a right triangle. In a right triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. Okay, fine. Just wanted to clarify that. Yes, children. Please do this. How will you find the area of triangle ABC?
ABC?
ABC. The right triangle. The right triangle.
Pythagoras theorem, ma'am.
Pythagoras theorem is not useful to find area.
No, ma'am. Half into base into
height. Half into base into height.
Half base into height. Half into 40 into 9. What if we find, suppose I forget to use that formula, half base into height. I find AC. I find the length of AC and I use Heron's formula. Will I get the same answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. When you find, so it's not that because it's a right triangle, you should only use half base into height. And it is not that you will get a different answer if you use Heron's formula. For a triangle, when you use, you can find the area of a triangle maybe using different ways. In all the different ways, you will get the same answer for area. The answers will not differ. So for ABC, when you use half base into height, whatever answer you will get, the same you should get when you use Heron's formula also. But use half base into height because you'll be saving time there. Fine, children. Start working.
Ma'am, AC is equal to 180 meters.
No, no, no. 180. No. You said AC is 180, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
No, no. It cannot be.
Ma'am, is AC is 41, ma'am.
Yeah, AC is 41. Correct. It's a square root of? AC is equal to square root of?
1,681, ma'am.
1,681. How did you find the square root?
Ma'am, I used Pythagoras theorem, ma'am. H square is equal to...
How did you find the value of... The square root of 1681. Not using the calculator, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am.
No, Mahitesh, my question is, how did you find the square root of 1681?
I used a calculator to check my answer, ma'am.
Okay, darling, but how did you find? Okay, you checked using the calculator, but how did you calculate?
By factorizing, ma'am. I took 1681, ma'am.
Okay.
If we put 2, ma'am, we'll get 5341. I used it and I did half, ma'am. After that, I used calculator to find the answer, ma'am.
Okay. What I'm at this point, what I would like to share with all the students is that we must know how to find the square root. I'll share the link if you want.
Ma'am, may I say? Okay, tell me. Ma'am, actually, ma'am, hypot square is equal to.
Shreyas, let me just finish. Children, I'll share a video which explains how to find the square root of a number. Please watch that in case you do not know. In case you've forgotten, you must have learned it in standard 8. Just in case you've forgotten, I'll share a video. Please watch that and recall. Yes, Shreyas, please tell me.
Ma'am, actually for this I too used that Pythagoras theorem, ma'am. Hypot square is equal to base square plus height square, ma'am.
You're correct.
By that we get 1681, ma'am.
Yeah.
Hypot square, no, ma'am. That square, if it comes to right hand side, means square root of 1681 is 41.
Correct. Yeah, 41. Yes, you're right. But how did you calculate the value of square root of 1681 was my question. Which method? What is the procedure you adopted to find the value of root of 1681? Calculator method.
I can't understand your question.
Okay, fine. How did you AC is equal to square root of 1681. AC is equal to 41. Who told you square root of 1681 is 41? How did you get 41 is my question.
By prime factorization.
Ma'am, long division, ma'am.
Long division, okay. That special long division method, okay. Shreyas, you got my question now?
Yes, ma'am, but I'm still confused.
No. After square root of AC is equal to square root of 1681, then you have to write AC is equal to, how did you write 41? How do you know root of 1681 is 41?
Ma'am, by using prime factorization method, ma'am.
Okay, read out. What have you worked there? Read out. 1681, what's the factor you have outside? Okay. Yeah, I think that was Ananya who wanted to say something. I'm not sure. Somebody wanted to say something. Yes?
Ma'am, I found the area of ABC, ma'am.
You found the area of ABC. Yeah, what's the area?
180, ma'am.
180. Okay. 180. Half base and height. 180 is right. Oh, I think Shreyas shared the area earlier. He said 180. For area, we were asking AC. Okay, fine. All right, children, continue. As I told you, I'll share the video as to how to find the square
root. Square root long division method, ma'am.
Yeah, correct. Yes. Not the regular long division method. Yes, I got you right, Kanishka. Yes, what's the semi perimeter of triangle ACD?
42, ma'am.
42, ma'am.
42. Okay. Found the area of the triangle ACD? Finding?
Point to complete.
Yes, ma'am. Finding.
Okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Please work.
Ma'am, is the area 6 root 66, ma'am?
No.
Ma'am, is it 126?
126, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, it is. Okay. I think that is from Priyadarshini, right? Not Priyadarshini, Pratiksha. Was it you, Pratiksha? Sorry?
It was Satvika.
Satvika. Okay, Satvika. Good, good. Satvika. Children, I'm sure you understand the question. You have to find the area cleansed by the two groups. And also which group cleaned more area and by how much? Let me wait for 3 minutes. Please check your answer thoroughly. Any doubts, please ask me. All right. Let's move on to the next one. No doubts.
No, ma'am.
Okay. All right, so this question says Kamala has a triangular field. Kamala has a triangular field with sides 240 meters, 200 meters, and 360 meters. Let's see it here in the figure. 200 meters, see here. 200 meters, 240 meters, and 360 meters. It is a triangle ABC. ABC, triangle ABC. Triangle ABC. You can see here 240 meters. AC is 240 meters. BC is 200 meters. And AB is 360 meters. Okay, so Kamala has a triangular field with sides 240 meters. Just a second, children. Just a second. Yeah, so she grows wheat here in this triangular portion ABC. She grows wheat in another triangular field with sides 240 meters. Where is 240? So the same thing, 240 meters, 320 meters, 400 meters adjacent to the previous field. Okay, so adjacent meaning just next to. Adjacent meaning just next to. So it is 240 here, this one. The other field is adjacent to the first field. See the sides. This side is common to both the fields. AC is the side that's common to both the fields. The second field is adjacent to the first one. The two fields share this side. AC 240 in the second field. 320 meters here. This is 320 meters and this is 400 meters. So the two triangular portions are ABC and ADC with AC common to both the triangles because the second triangular field is adjacent to the first one. Don't look at this line segment CE. ABC and ADC are the two triangular portions spoken about here, till here, adjacent to the previous field, till here. So ABC, ADC, 200, 240, 360, the second field, 240, 400, and 320. All right, adjacent to the previous field, she wanted to grow potatoes and onions, however you pronounce it, potatoes. All right, so I'm used to saying potatoes, though it is potatoes. Onions, though I say onions, I'm used to that. Okay, so potatoes and onions in the figure. All right, so the second field, she wants to grow two vegetables in the second field. Well, in the first field, she grows only this grain, wheat. So what she does, she divided the field into two parts by joining the midpoint of the longest side to the opposite vertex and grew potatoes in one part and onions in the other part. How much area in hectares we have to find? How much area has been used for wheat, potatoes, and onions? They've given you this information that an area of 1 hectare is equal to 10,000 meters square. Okay, let's now understand the question or the information better. So in this triangular portion ABC, she grows wheat. And in this triangular portion ADC, she wants to grow two types of crops or these two vegetables, potatoes and onions. So what she does is, the longest side in the second triangular field is 400 meters. Because the others are 240 and 320. So 240, 320, 400. 400 is the longest side in the second triangular field. She marks E, the midpoint of AD, the midpoint of the longest side in the second triangular field. She marks the midpoint and she joins that to the opposite vertex C. So CE, CE is the line segment that connects the midpoint of AD. AD is the longest side. AD is the longest side of the second triangular field. E is the midpoint of AD. It's given that she marks off the midpoint of the longest side. So E is the midpoint of AD. And what she does is she joins, she connects E to C. She connects E to the opposite vertex C. So EC is the line segment from the midpoint of AD to the vertex C. Is this much clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. So now we need to understand the property of the line segment CE. We are talking about the second triangle ACD. We're talking about the second triangle ACD in which CE is a line segment from the vertex C to the midpoint of the opposite side. A line segment from the vertex to the midpoint of the opposite side is the median of the triangle. CE is a median on the side AD. And the property of the median is that it divides the triangle into two portions equal in area. The two portions need not be identical. They need not be identical. They'll have the same area. In a triangle, let's understand the property of a median in a triangle. The median divides the triangle into two triangles equal in area. The two triangles, those two triangular pieces need not be identical, but they'll have the same area. Like when you consider a rectangle of length 8 and breadth 2, a rectangle of length 8 and breadth 2 has area 8 into 2, 16 square units. If you take up a square of side 4 units, a square of side 4 units also has the same area, 4 into 4, 16 square units. So a rectangle with dimensions 8 by 2, length 8, breadth 2, has area 16 square units. And so will be the area of a square whose side is 4 units. So they will look different. They are not identical. A rectangle with sides 8 and 2 will look different from a square with side 4. But they have the same area. 8 2s are 16, 4 4s are 16. Similarly, here, these two triangles need not be identical, but they'll have the same area. In a triangle, or the median in a triangle, divides it into two smaller triangles equal in area. So in triangle ACD, in the second triangle, what is CE? CE is a line segment from the vertex C to the midpoint of the opposite side. And that's what a median is. Now, if you draw, now, what's the midpoint of this side CD, children? Now, when you take the side CD, at 160, you will have the midpoint, right? At 160, yes, you'll have the midpoint. So when you join A to this midpoint, you're drawing the median. When you mark off the midpoint of this side CD at 160, and when you join A to that point, which is exactly 160, midway, So supposing you say we call the point F, we call this point F, which is a midpoint of CD. If you join AF, AF will be the median on the side CD. AF will be the median on the side CD. So on either sides of AF, on this side and the other side of AF, you'll have two triangles. Those two pieces will be equal in area. Now forget CE, forget AF, forget the CE. Don't see this line segment CE. I'm erasing it. See, I'm removing it. Okay, it's gone now. Now forget AF also. Now let's take the midpoint of AC at 120. Let's take the midpoint of AC. We'll call the point G. G. We'll call this point G, which is the midpoint of AC. We'll call it G. Now when we join DG, when you join DG, DG is the median from the vertex D to the side AC. And what happens is DG divides the triangle into two smaller triangles equal in area, because it's a median. That's the property of a median. Is that understood, children? Do we understand the property of the median in a triangle?
Yes, ma'am.
The median divides the triangle into two smaller triangles equal in area. So now the question is, in how much area is Kamala growing wheat? In how much area is she growing potatoes? In how much area is she growing onions? That's the question. So you have to find the area in which she grows wheat, you simply have to find the area of triangle ABC. For potatoes and onions, find the area of the whole triangle. Find the area of the whole triangle, 240, 400, 320. Find the area of the whole triangle and divide by 2. Divide by 2. Suppose the area of the whole triangle is 10,000 meters square. 5,000 she's using for potatoes and 5,000 for onions. Because CE is the median, it divides a triangle into two smaller triangles equal in area. So Kamala has a triangular piece of land ABC. She has a triangular piece of land ABC. Adjacent to ABC, she has another triangular piece of land ACD. ACD. So you see that AC is the side common to both the triangles. Now in the second triangle, what she does is she marks the midpoint of the longest side AD. She chooses the longest side. It's not that the median will fall only on the longest side. You can draw a median to every side in the triangle. A triangle has three medians. A triangle has three medians. To every side, you can draw the median from the opposite vertex. To every side, you can draw the median from the opposite vertex. So she chooses the longest side. She chooses the longest side. She marks the midpoint of the longest side and she connects this vertex C to the midpoint, thereby dividing the second triangle into two smaller triangular portions equal in area. Very smart lady. Okay. So that. Now look for the working here. Please do it now in the class. I'm right here, children. As you work, any questions, ask me then and there. You don't finish the answer and save your doubts till the end of the answer.
Ma'am, they haven't given that root 2 is 1.414, no, ma'am.
Yeah, it's not given. I have used it. It will be given. It will be given to you in the question. If it is not given, you don't have to use the value of root 2. You can just leave it as 16,000 root 2. And when you have 16,000 root 2, when you divide by 10,000, when you divide 16,000 root 2 by 10,000, it'll be 1.6 root 2 meter square. You can leave it like that. Sorry, 1.6 root 2 hectares. If the value of root 2, see root 2, root 3, you need to remember. Maybe you can just use it by yourself. Root 2 and root 3. It is generally supplied to you in the question. Otherwise, you can use root 2, root 3, you can just use by yourself. Other values like root 7 or root 11 will be provided. Only if provided, you have to use the value. Otherwise, you can just leave it as a cert. Now, in this case, if supposing you're not given the value of root 2 and you leave it as 16,000 root 2, 16,000 root 2 divided by 10,000 to convert it to hectares, divided by 10,000. So three zeros will get cancelled. You'll have 16 by 10, which is 1.6. So it'll be 1.6 root 2 hectares. 1.6 root 2 hectares. 1.6 root 2 hectares. To convert meter square to hectares, divide by 10,000 because 1 hectare is 10,000 meter square. 1 hectare is 10,000 meter square. Did I give you time to write the question, children? No, right? I don't think I gave you time to write the question. Please write down the question. It here also.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Ma'am, why are we dividing area of ABC by 10,000, ma'am?
To convert the area which is in meter square to hectares. Hectare is a unit of area. An area of 10,000 meter square. Okay, now imagine a square or any piece of land which has an area of 10,000 meter square. To understand better, you can imagine or you can consider a square field of side 100 meters.
Okay, ma'am.
A square field, okay? A square field of side 100 meters. So how much is 100 meters? During sports day at school, that distance 100 meters running race, that distance, you can just visualize that 100 meters running race.
Okay, ma'am.
That is 100 meters. So imagine a square field of side 100 meters. So length 100 meters, breadth also 100 meters. The area of that field is 100 into 100, 10,000 meters square. Now, if you own a piece of land which has an area of 10,000 meters square, you can say that you have 1 hectare of land. If you have a piece of land which has an area of 10,000 meters square, 100 meters into 100 meters, because it's a square piece of land, 100 length, 100 breadth, 100 into 100, 10,000 meters square. So if a piece of land has an area of 10,000 meters square, you say that the area of the land is 1 hectare. So 10,000 meters square is 1 hectare. 20,000 meter square is 2 hectares. 30,000 meter square is 3 hectares and so on.
Okay, ma'am.
So now so 20,000 meter square is 2 hectares, right? So you divide 20,000 by 10,000 to get 2 hectares.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, completed.
Completed? Okay. So I'll tell you how these factors happen. So when you have these numbers, see children, the question is the area of field on which wheat is grown, the area of field on which potatoes are grown, and the area of field on which onions are grown. So simply find the areas of the triangles. That's all it is. For wheat, the sides are 360, 240, and 200. Semi-perimeter and then area, 440, 160. Just observe the numbers carefully. There's 440, 200, and 160. So now we have a 200 here. I've just rearranged the numbers. I've written 200, 400, 40, and 160. In this step, I've just rearranged the numbers. 200, 400, 40, and 160. Now there is 200 here, and this 400 can be written as 200 into 2. Why like this? Because now we have two 200s, so one will come out of the square root. You don't have to write all the factors 2 into 2 into 5 into 5 into all that, you know. You can save time. You just save time. Instead of breaking down 200 completely, 400 completely, you can also do this. You just have to get rid of the square root symbol. So 200 as it is, 400 can be written as 200 into 2. So that way you get two 200, so one will come out. And then here 40 and 160. I've written 40 as it is and 160 as 40 into 4. That way we're getting another 40. So from these two 200s, one 200 out. From two 40s, 140 out. And then what have I written? Have I gone wrong here? 4 root 2. It'll be 2 root 2, right? Nobody pointed out this mistake. It's not 4 here, it's 2. See, that shows you've not been working carefully. It's a 2 here. See, children, since I'm typing all this, I might go wrong while typing. I might go wrong. Okay, so this is 2, children. From these two 200s, one 200 out. From two 40s, 140 out. And then we have a 2 and a 4 under the square root. We have a 2 and a 4 under the square root. Now 4 will come out as 2. This is 2 here. 4 comes out as 2. Because square root of, because 4 is 2 into 2, right? 4 is 2 into 2. So from 2 2s, 1 2 comes out. 2 40s, 140 out. 200s, 1 200 out. Then we have a 2 and a 4 under the square root. And 4 is 2 into 2. You can just do that in your mind. 4 is 2 into 2. Just do it in your mind. And 1 2 comes out. So this is 2. And this 2 remains under the square root. So root 2. This 2 remains under the square root. So we have root 2. So 200 into 40 into 2. Which is 16,000. 16,000 root 2. No, I'm disappointed that nobody found out this mistake.
Actually, I have done it this summary by myself, ma'am.
Oh, okay, fine. All right. So 16,000 root 2. The value of root 2 is 1.414. And we get 22,624. This is in meter square. Now, we are expected to find the area in hectares. So divide this answer in meter square by 10,000 to convert it to hectares. So which is 2.2624 or 2.26 hectares. So on 2.26 hectares of land, she grows wheat. And for the other two, just find the area of the whole triangle ACD. Find the area of the whole triangle ACD. So we get 3.84 hectares. So the areas of these two triangles will be 3.84 divided by 2, 1.92 hectares. Because by the property of the median, you can divide the total area by 2, 1.92 hectares. So she grows potatoes on 1.92 hectares of land and onions also on 1.92 hectares of land. And here, 480, 160, 80 and 240. So this 480, this 160 here, 480 can be written as 160 into 3. There's 160 here, so this 480 can be written as 160 into 3. 160 into 3. This 160 as it is. And 240 is 80 into 3. 240 is 80 into 3. So this 80 as it is, 240 is 80 into 3. So from 2 160s, 1 160 out. From 2 3s, 1 3 out. And from 2 80s, 1 80 out. Out of the square root. So like this, we get rid of the square root completely. There is no factor that remains under the square root. Yes, I think I gave you sufficient time to write. Any doubts?
No, ma'am.
Others? Okay, others?
No doubt, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Why Pranav is active these days? What happened to Pranav? Okay. Write down this question and draw the figure, children. Use a scale and a pencil.
Completed, ma'am.
All right. Take a picture of the answer, children. Work this, and any doubts you have, we'll discuss in the next class. Use the answer and complete. Finish working. Work out the answer. Your doubts will be handled in the next class. Yeah, take a picture of this one, children. This question says the angle contained by the last two sides is the right angle. Remember, you have to make the figure for all this. The figure is not provided. The figure is not provided. The sides of a quadrangular field taken in order. Taken in order. So if you call your field ABCD, AB is 26. The sides of a quadrangular field, that is like you say triangular field. If it's in the shape of a triangle, we say triangular field. If it's in the shape of a quadrilateral, we say quadrangular field. Triangle, triangular field. Quadrilateral, quadrangular field. So it's in the shape of a quadrilateral and the sides taken in order. So if you call it ABCD, AB is 26, BC is 27, CD is 7, and AD is 24. The angle contained by the last two sides, which are the last two sides? CD and AD. The last two sides here. AB is the first side. AB is the first side. BC is the second side. CD is the third side. And DA is the fourth side. Last two sides, the third and the fourth side. Last two sides, CD and AD. The angle contained by the last two sides is a right angle. So this one is a right angle. This is a right angle. The angle contained by the last two sides is a right angle. Okay. Take a picture. Complete all this by the next class. I'll keep the exams also available till Sunday, children. Please complete it. Please check your account for the exams. Four exams are enabled. Please complete it by Sunday. Yeah, take a picture of this question. Answer. This is simple. If interested, you can work this. Take a picture of the answer. Yeah, this one also. Find the area using both the methods, children. Find the area of one triangle, double it, and find the area of the rhombus. That's one way. Also find the length of the diagonal. Length of the diagonal and use the formula half D1, D2. You can find the area of the rhombus in two different ways. You can find the area of one triangle and double it to find the area of the rhombus. Or you can also use the formula half D1, D2. I want you to find the area of this figure in both the ways. Doubling the area of the triangle and also by using the formula half D1, D2.
Ma'am, can you show the 28th question answer?
8 answer, no?
Yes, ma'am, just 1 second.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am, thank you.
Okay. Yeah, this also important question. Please work this. I'm not showing the answer for this. I'm not showing you the answer slide for this. We'll see the answer in the class, next class. The figure is not provided, though you see it below the question. You have to read the question and make the figure. It's not given. All right, children. So that's it for today's session. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you, children. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, children. Thank you. Good night.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Good night.